Hey guys, what's up? It's Vitensby, the Starcraft 2 dude, back in the Starcraft 2 all-in-one launcher versus the insane AI. This video was inspired by my first video response ever from user Cyrthomas. He says, "Hi, I checked out the Starcraft 2 all-in-one launcher. It is absolutely great for practice while battle.net is down. I beat the insane AI and made a vid. I tried to respond to your challenge video. Not so pro with YouTube, so don't know if it worked. Hope you check it out." Well, I did check it out, Cyrthomas, and I was amazed that you were able to pull off the Mutalisk strategy, which is my favorite strategy in this game. I've done so many videos on it. So this video was inspired by you, sir. What he did was, is he found out that the computer, when you send Zerglings over to their expansion early, will basically sit their units there and defend their expansion and not attack you. So him, like me, kind of figured out the computer, kind of figured out the way the AI works, and just like I did, kind of hacksawed his way into defeating it. I also wanted to give a shout out to two other users who had beat the insane AI. We have Grendelbrood. He says, "Hi, I beat the insane AI using Terran against all three races." Fantastic. I hope that you can do a video response because I'd love to see how Terran can pwn all three of the races. Siege tanks? "But I must say the computer attacked in much more violent waves than in your video. I use the all-in-one loader AI. It's crazy. So far, the only map I can win on is Desert Oasis." I don't know what it is about Desert Oasis, but I heard so many Terran and Protoss players QQing about that map in the beta. I'm sorry that Zerg actually has a definitive advantage on this map, because it takes your units eons to get around to our base, and we can just spam mutas and shove them down your throat. I apologize for the Desert Oasis IMBA. I had nothing to do with that map being created, I swear, but I love to beat Terran and Protoss players on that map. I got another response from Wow Dominic, another one of my subscribers. He says, "Yo, I beat the insane AI earlier today with Toss versus Terran. I went a 2-gate with a proxy pylon and his natural, which I've noticed the AIs don't do anything about. And knowing that the insane AI mines faster than me, I put pylons in his mineral line, which screwed him around. And then I went 6-gate with 110 upgrades. I believe that's attack and armor upgrades, and massed stalkers for the win. Bit of cannon creeping in there too, but hey, whatever you can do to win, right? Whatever you can do to win is right." Wow, Dominic, if you get a chance, if you got the equipment, make a video response. I'd love to see your fucking with the AI's brain, because that's pretty tight. In unrelated news, on gamereplays.org, in the Company of Heroes section, I've been organizing a Tales of Heroes reunion show. Many years ago, I did a show with a friend of mine called Tales of Heroes. It was on the Relic RTS game called Company of Heroes. We did it for 61 episodes together, and then my good friend Rogers took over my position for the last few episodes of the show. So if you're a fan of Company of Heroes, we are accepting one user-submitted replay. How to get your replay selected for the show? It needs to be a under one hour replay. I can't stress that enough. But the closer to an hour, the better, because in Company of Heroes, like a 50-minute game is pretty epic. So it needs to be under an hour. Go to gamereplays.org and post it there. And then use the contact form on my website with the link, include the link, to make it easier for me to forward to all the people involved. This is a reunion show, and I have like a good half dozen people that I need to send this email to. So that would be the first thing that we're going to do. The second thing is a Bridger versus Vitensby Tales of Heroes War Part 2. It's a rematch. Bridger lost to my allies in the last Tales of Heroes War. So he's back for blood, and we really thought that we could give you guys a pretty fun show with that. The third thing that we're doing is a featured match, like we used to have back in the day, with arguably the best Axis player of all time, a good friend of mine as well, Aniketos. He's a Dawn of War expert, he's a Company of Heroes expert, and he's playing StarCraft 2 now, so you watch out, Gosu Pros, because this guy's pretty uber. Versus one of the best Allies player of all time, Mexico, aka Sexico. And the hosts so far are Bridger, we got Some Bloke, we got Ahenian, we got Rogers, we got Aniketos, we got Mexico, and we got myself. So this is going to be a really Big deal for the Company of Heroes community. It's been many years since we did a show for them, and I thought it was about time that we came back and at least did one more final episode. And hey, if this goes really well, then who knows? Who knows what'll happen? So go ahead and enjoy the rest of this video, and if you're a fan of Company of Heroes, go ahead and check out GameReplays.org, Company of Heroes sec. I'm going to leave a link for you guys so that you can find this thread over on GameReplays.org. In case you're not familiar with GameReplays.org, this is a real-time strategy game, an RTS game, fan site. It's one of the best replay sites on the internet. And if you haven't checked it out, if you're just a fan of Team Liquid or one of the other replay sites out there, go check out GameReplays.org because I really think that you guys will enjoy what's there. So go ahead and enjoy the rest of this video. This is Vitensby, the Starcraft 2 dude, signing out.